If you're new to studying the Bible, here are 5 practical tips for a better Bible study. You may have heard of different terms when it comes to studying the Bible. There's daily devotion, QT, or quiet time. Essentially, they all mean spending time in the Word of God and connecting with God. First up, we have to identify our why. Why do you want to study the Bible? For many of us, maybe when we just became a Christian, we were told by the church that we have to study the Word of God and that we should read it daily. But instead of reading it because someone else told us to read it, we must develop the passion for reading God's Word and to connect with God, wanting to get to know more about Him, wanting to hear from Him. Oftentimes, Satan will cause us to think that it's really hard to read the Bible consistently. And I'm not saying that it's easy. A lot of times we encounter challenges, not just for new Christians, but seasoned Christians as well. So it's very crucial for us to kind of be aware of what are the struggles, what are the obstacles, and how we should tackle them when it comes to studying the Bible. Planning. When and where? When? Many would suggest to do it in the morning because that's when your mind is most fresh and without a lot of the distractions. And when you're prioritizing to read it in the morning, you ensure that you give the best time to God. For me, I'm a morning person, so reading the Bible in the morning is not very difficult for me. And being a Christian for more than 10 years, it has taken me a long time to build this consistency. But I can tell you, once you have it, it's so good. Having that time spent with God every single day helps you to really have peace and joy that you know are from God alone. We must schedule a time in our schedule that day so then we make sure that we have that time spent with God. Just like our non-negotiables, we always brush our teeth when we wake up in the morning or when we go to sleep, we always shower at night, we all have some sort of routine. A lot of times when we don't schedule it in our routine, we're just waiting for when we have time to read it. And for most of us, our to-do list is really long. So not only do we not have time to do our laundry, wash our dishes, if we don't make it in our schedule, it's really hard to sit down and study the Word of God. If God is so important in your life, you will always prioritize a time to read your Bible, to connect with Him. So find what works best for you and stick to it. Now, where? Having a specific one location in your room or in your home, like a worship station. Try not to do your daily devotion at all different places every time. When you have a set place, your mind and your body naturally and automatically know that you're preparing yourself for your devotion time. Again, we want to build a regular routine and consistency, which are key to your success in reading your Bible. I say consistency is definitely the number one obstacle or difficulty that most people encounter when it comes to reading your Bible or doing your daily devotion every day. But don't worry, if you fall off the track, just start over and it's day one again. Take me as an example. I've been a Christian for more than 10 years, and I've only started to have a consistent daily devotion since 2020. I've always tried to read the Bible every day. I've joined many different plans, and I've set alarms, tried all different types of apps, or even the reading plans. I was using a Chinese Bible that was gifted to me when I got baptized back in Macau. I didn't realize that my lack of understanding when I was reading Chinese Bible actually prevented me from wanting to read the Bible because I couldn't understand it completely. Even though I'm full Chinese and I speak Chinese fluently, I didn't realize that I was able to comprehend the English version more efficiently. And I think English is just more direct and straightforward. I was quite frustrated at that time because I didn't seem to be able to find a routine and being consistent in my daily devotion time. My boyfriend at the time, which is my husband now, got me this Life Application Bible. And I talk about this in my last video. If you haven't checked it out yet, I highly recommend that you watch it, where I talk about 5 must-have essential Bible study tools, especially when you're a new beginner. I talked about this Life Application Study Bible, why it's so good and how it had benefited me. This Bible has definitely changed the game when I'm trying to pursue a more consistent daily devotion time. First, it's in English. It's also in a version that is easier for me to understand. And I talked about in my last video that my favorite version is the NLT version. Secondly, their commentaries are written by scholars and experts who provided in-depth explanations and interpretation of the text. They also give you a historical context, cultural insights, and help you to understand the theological implication of the passages. That leads me to my next tip for better Bible study is to find a translation that you can understand most. Next tip is to read the Bible in smaller sections. Now I get it, when you just started, you're so excited, you're very passionate, and you just want to immerse in the Word of God, and you want to read as much as you can each time. But trust me, reading a small section each time can help goes a long way when it comes to building a successful and consistent Bible study. Not only is it less overwhelming and easier for you to stick to it, but also reading a small section each time helps you to have a deeper understanding of the passage and focus on just one point that God is teaching you that day. Now, having a mentor can be very helpful when you're just starting out, and it goes a long way in your Bible study journey. And you will definitely encounter questions when you're reading it. Find someone who's more experienced or mature in the spiritual journey. That way you can also share your insights when you're reading the Bible. Reading it with a partner helps keep that accountability.
Two people are better off than one, for they can help each other succeed, says Ecclesiastes chapter 4, verse 9.
Remember, before you begin your Bible study, take a moment to pray for wisdom and understanding. Ask God for a quiet heart so then you can receive His guidance and how you can apply it in your everyday life. Now, if you want to know the five essential must-have Bible study tools you need right now, check out this video up here. As always, stay curious and keep seeking the truth. I'll see you in the next one. Bye.